Of course, we'll continue our coverage here on WESH 2 News. Meanwhile, NASA engineers are again dealing with a hydrogen leak as they perform a test of the fuel tanking on the Artemis 1 SLS rocket today. This is ahead of what they hope to be another launch attempt on Tuesday. WESH 2 Scott Heidler is live for us. He's at the Kennedy Space Center. What's the latest, Scott?
Well, it was just after 10 o'clock this morning, a few hours into this tanking process, that another hydrogen leak was detected. And this is very similar to the one that we saw that scrubbed the launch back on September 3rd. And it happened at the same time in the tanking process, too. Just as the launch teams were transitioning from slow fill to fast fill of the supercooled liquid hydrogen, their plates called the quick disconnect that hold the fuel lines that go from the source into the SLS rocket stack. They fall back just before launch. The sensors in the quick disconnect read 7% hydrogen. The minimum safety level is 4%. So the engineers used a tactic that they tried back on September 3rd, allowing the quick disconnect to warm up, hoping the gap that's causing the leak will reseat. This time, they lowered the pressure, hoping the leak will stop. They restarted pumping the hydrogen about 40 minutes ago, started on slow fill, and again transitioning to fast fill, and that's happening right now. Since that last launch attempt, engineers replaced two seals they hoped would correct the situation, and they are trying a new, kinder, gentler fueling process. So what happens here today will tell us what could possibly happen next Tuesday. That's the next attempted launch window, or if they'll have to roll the SLS rocket stack back into the vehicle assembly building. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, WESH 2 News.